is 12 o'clock on a Wednesday, and this is the Weiser product review live. Woo! I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
Good boy. And on this week's show, first of all, we're going to go over to the bar and do a demonstration of, what are we going to call this trick, Sean, without giving
anything
away?
It's the Tango gimmick poker chip, and it's like you said, it's something,
something you might find on a beach.
Yes.
And you get three others with it as well.
My friend's got one.
Let's go over to the bar and do this. Let's do it right now. Let's go over here. You go in there first. And we can do a little demonstration of what you can do with these four poker chips. Audience, do you want to come on in? Come on in a bit closer. Do it on you.
Just too close.
There we go. So there's the four poker chips. You can show them on both sides. Nothing else inside the hand. The coins are going to jump. Sorry, coins. I'm doing my normal patter. The poker chips are going to jump when I wiggle the thumbs. So now there's only three and one just here like this. Can you hold out your right hand but leave your thumb up in the air like that? This is going to be the next one to jump. You're going to see it jump when I pull on the thumb like that. And now I've only got two over here. Just like that, and this is not when it happens. Remember, this is not when it happens. That's not when it happens. This is when it happens. I wiggle the thumbs, and that's the next one to go across, and now the very last one. One, two, three, four. Just do me a favor. Just pick up the top chip and just put it into my hand like that. Close your hand. Close your hand, that's good. You're gonna see this one go from here, here, open your hand. All four poker chips inside the hand, ladies and gentlemen. There we go. That was all right, I got away with it. It's weird, because muscle memory makes you want to do it with two, like you're still doing it with
£2 coins.
Because I'm used to doing it with £2 coins all the time. So this is what it is, without saying too much about it. You probably know exactly how this is done. But we played around with it, didn't we? Because it looks pretty invisible. We've all had a look at this. The gimmick you get with it is very, very well made.
It's not going to break. It's good.
It's quite well made. It's quite indestructible. Chips look good. You can have a close look at those, John, if you want to come in nice and close. They look really, really good. And the gimmick, because of the colour involved, is actually quite indetectable. And you could quite comfortably leave those in your hand and nobody's going to see a thing. Like Sean said, they're well made. Online instructions, you get other instructions with it, but there's a whole host of resources available online for this gimmick. Mm. The only thing is, it's poker chips. So you're never going to use this when you've got a choice of doing it with, say, a pile of £2 coins because they look real.
I disagree with you.
Okay.
I did loads of gigs at casinos.
You do your casino demonstrations and that. Yeah. So you'd be right to say that this suits you a lot more. Me personally, I'm never going to change from £2 coins. Mm-hmm. It's always better. But I know you work in casinos, so you could bring these in as a natural object.
Yeah.
I'm going to give this 89% because it's very, very good, but I'm not going to use it. But the quality of the gimmick is very good. If you like what you see, you'll enjoy using it.
I am using it at my next casino gig. 92%.
It's fair enough. It is well made. You also get access to online instructions with 50 other routines involving other coins and gaffes of this nature. Shin Lim presents Danny Weiser's version of a tournament restored card called Triage. So this is what happened. Within seconds of the trailer coming on, you see Shin Lim and he's got bits of cards in his mouth and he goes bang. Nice sound effect on the trailer and the card is restored. It looks absolutely incredible.
It does.
You've got other moments where you've got bits of cards. You've never seen a tournament restored card this good before because there's bits of card. Click, throw it on the table, spin it on your finger. Whatever you want to do, that card restores instantly.
And throw it in the air.
It looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It does.
Talk about the routine. First of all, Shin's routine.
Shin's routine.
No live performance, I'll just point that out.
Yeah, Shin's routine, you have it in a paper clip. Not paper clip, but like a little mini bulldog clip. You have like four.
No, first of all, that was one of them. But the routine he did where he tells the story of a guy that tore up the
card.
No,
he put it in his mouth.
No, he tore up the card and then he said, so I didn't know what to do. So I just put it in my pocket.
I didn't see that as the main routine.
Well, that's
Shin's
routine.
I know he did that first, but I saw that as a... I couldn't...
From what I remember, we have watched about 12 things today, but from what I remember, that was Shin's routine, the tearing it up, putting the card in the pocket, coming out with the bits, restoring it, returning it back to the deck, then just turning it over casually and giving them the card.
The other two things on there were better.
Right, okay. You like Tom's routine.
Tom Enderfield?
Tom Enderfield did a routine, which was like a version of... David Williamson's Torn and Restored Transposition.
It was the visuals, because you're expecting him to tear up the card, put it in his mouth, then it restores, and you're expecting that to be the restored card, aren't you?
Yes.
And it's not. The card that was on the pack is now in your mouth.
Yeah.
And then the torn up card is now not in you. So the torn up pieces are in your mouth.
He takes the card.
The torn up pieces appear on the top of the pack, and the card that was on the top of the pack now is the one in your mouth.
They visually transpose at that moment.
So rather than it being a restoration, it's the two things it's swapping places.
The torn card changes places with another card which is already on top of the deck. And it looks good. The misdirection works very, very well. Shin does the explanation for that. You can see that working in the real world.
It's using moves that are already used by us as well to do... What can we say about that thing that I'm
DLs.
DL, and then the bit that you need to do a bit of... You know, you've torn them up. You don't need to do a bit.
Yeah,
that's a familiar, easy-to-do move. It's logical, and it's better. In Shin's version earlier on...
Where he says, I'm going to put the card in my pocket.
I'm just going to put my hand in my pocket with the card in it just for a minute.
We were both a bit shocked by that.
That's not... I don't think that's going to... If you're performing to a spectator going, hey, I'm going to try and fool you with a magic trick, which if you're paid to do a gig, people are watching you to be fooled, and you put your hand in your pocket... For no reason, they're going, what?
This guy tore up a card, and I had no idea what to do, so I just put it in my pocket.
And then I brought it back out again. It doesn't make sense.
It's not a good routine. I think that's the main problem with this. We are not doubting the fact that the actual restoration moment looks brilliant.
Yeah, it does.
It's probably that moment is second best to Rewind by Michael Chatelain. I still think if you're going to do an ultra clean version of Torn and Restored Card, I actually really like Michael Chatelain's Rewind. I think that's one of the best versions out there. It looks so clean, it looks impossible. Quite similar to the Triage gimmick in a way, which uses a different method, but still completely slight free, and it's instant. It's not piece by piece, it's instant. Four pieces, all apart, bang, they're all restored. The actual moment of the restoration looks very magical, looks impossible, it's instant. My problem is... It's all the routines that are supplied, including Tom's, which is the best of the bunch. The strong moment of magic doesn't have a very nice routine to sit in.
And I think it's the blocking of the routines that does this for me. I think even if it was done in a different order, so when you... There's a bit where you wave over the card to make the creases go away, and then you do your DL or whatever after that. And I think maybe if it was all done in a different order, it'd look a lot nicer for me.
It looks okay, but once again, viewers, there wasn't a live performance on the DVD to convince us that this can work in the real world. It's always nice if it's a routine where you need to chat. You need time misdirection. Where it's something that you need reassurance how something plays out over a period of time, you really need to see it work.
Absolutely.
It doesn't come with a DVD. It comes with a very nice box. Inside, you go, okay. And then you've got to spend about 15 minutes setting up the gimmick the first time you use it. I'm not sure how long it would last. Certainly not forever. Tom's looked a bit of a state on the actual video, and you would need to renew the gimmick, which they explain how to do.
But Shinlim even makes an apology for Tom about his video.
He says it's a bit of a state.
Tom's is a bit of a state. He wants to apologise for that.
Yeah, it looked a bit bad. But you get downloadable instructions. No DVD, once again. Yeah, downloadable instructions are brilliant when you've got a good internet connection. But what happened last week, John, when we wanted to take a look at this?
Bad internet?
Well, the server was down, wasn't it? The server was down for a whole day, so we couldn't view the instructions. Also, we'd like to have a DVD as well as the instructions.
There's loads of, just in England, I don't know what America's like, but in England, there's loads of like villages and stuff. My dad lives in a village where I grew up, right? You can't stream videos in the village. They're paying just the same for the broadband, right? Whatever, rant. But you can't stream videos, which means if there's a whole market of people that live in villages in England.
Downloads.
They can't watch,
Downloads are great, downloads are brilliant.
You never crash.
Yeah, downloads are brilliant, but let's have the choice of both.
Yes,
let's have the option of doing the download, but let's have a DVD as well. That's what I'd like to say on this. But Triage, as an effect, how much are you going to give it?
I don't think it's very good. 52%.
52, I'm going to give it 61%. Mm. That's all I'm going to give it.
9% more.
Reboxed by Rian Lehman actually came with a DVD.
In a box.
And it was a good DVD, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Do you know what? It wasn't flashy production values or anything like that. It wasn't fantastic cameras, but we got everything we needed.
Well, what was great about it, you got this live performance, but you actually got it filmed from the magician's point of view as well, didn't you?
So
you were basically seeing a backstage view of him performing it.
He certainly wouldn't use it as a showreel because we could see what was going on. But that's what you want to see. If we want to see this on DVDs more, if it's something that needs to play out in front of spectators.
We're buying this to learn how to do it, so we need to see how the magician's performing it.
Yeah, and Rian, he starts off, he does a great...
Straight into the DVD, bam, you see it.
Straight, great ambitious card routine, gives you a lot of confidence that you can use it in the real world.
With the gimmick in the deck.
The deck is very free, even though, like you say, the gimmick is hidden in the deck at that point. And at the end of the routine, as a kicker to his ambitious card routine, he said, what I'm going to do is get the cards into the box in an instant, in a moment of visual magic, clicks his fingers, and the cards, it's the opposite of unboxing by Nicholas Lawrence.
It's reboxing.
They rebox straight away. And there's a great quote from Nicholas Lawrence on the back of the DVD. I love this. Rian has put a lot of work into this effect, and it shows Nicholas Lawrence. So Nicholas has obviously endorsed it as well. But the moment is really, really good. It's really strong. We picked it up.
We did.
We started practicing with it. The DVD gives a lot of different ways to do it. We can't say too much about it.
We got a little bit excited, and then we got even more excited.
Yeah, we kind of got it.
We watched
the first 15 minutes of the 32-minute DVD, and we thought, yeah, let's go and try that. And we couldn't get it to work exactly. Then we did what everybody
three
should
more
do.
Minutes. We watched three more minutes.
There's about another 10 minutes with a different way to do it, and that we preferred.
We did prefer that.
And in the real world, it would play a lot better than it does on camera. It looks very deceptive in real life because you've got that natural misdirection where they glance up at you, and when they glance back down, the whole deck is reboxed. How much are you going to give it?
76%.
I'm going to give it 85%. I think it's a great moment. I would consider using it. I just don't think it's going to be a regular, have a regular spot in my set. But it does look good. Looks great. It was fun to play with as well. Mm-hmm. And it's a strong moment of visual magic.
9% more again. Next up, we've got Freedom Writer.
Yes.
It's Paul Harris Presents, but it's by Mark Allen.
Mark Allen, introduced by Bro Gilbert. Yeah. And Matthew Johnson's on the DVD as well. Well, do you know what? It's a DVD there. You're not going to believe this. It's downloadable instructions.
Ooh.
No DVD, but they've done this very awful thing. They've made a box that looks like it could hold a DVD. So when I go and look at it, I go, there it is.
Well, you are very excited when you look at it because there's
very
so much
excited.
In there.
But I'm knocking marks off for no DVD because we went to look at the instructions last week and the server was down. So we've said that already, but it wasn't working.
I think you need a new server.
It's nothing to do with us. It's where they were hosted and you couldn't access the instructions for 24 hours. So we need to get DVDs as well as this fantastic service as downloads.
There's magicians twitching all
we've
over
said
the world
that.
Trying to download.
We've said that.
Weekly fix.
We've said
magic.
That. Right, so Freedom Writer, yes. Tell us a bit about an effect you can do with the Freedom Writer.
Any sort of mentalism-y type thing. An effect would be that you show everybody, our favourite effect would you show everybody an envelope, a red envelope.
So we went out and tried this, didn't we?
We did went out and tried it.
We actually went and performed this on some guys at the pool table today, did it on them, and we're not going to show the whole thing. We are going to edit this performance in the same way that they've edited their trailer, because we want to preserve the full method for Mark, Bro and the rest of the team.
It's very, very good though.
But the reaction was amazing.
I mean, if you're, if the reaction, are we going to show the footage now, or should I come?
The footage is going on the screen.
Okay, here's the thing. If you're already somebody that's using this type of gimmick, you'll know what it is by the name of the product.
Yeah.
This is genius for you because if you can already do this well, if you're already using this sort of thing, then you need to upgrade to this. That's what I'd say.
You get a very nice moment where you. Basically, you've got the envelope on their hand and you can show your hands. You've got nothing inside your hands. So it's disarming them all the time. You're dispelling the possible solutions, which that solution is there normally.
But now it's not there. So everything's fine.
Nothing in your hands at all. You go inside one envelope, show that envelope. They can have a look at that envelope and then you let them take out the envelope inside. And in the case of the performance today, it's already written out and it says... you will pick this number. And it was spot on, got exactly the right number. And of all the magic we did today...
The strongest reaction.
It got the strongest reaction. Just something like name a number, and then that number is written down like you've predicted their thoughts. Could be anything, a PIN number.
It's direct mentalism.
Yeah.
There's nothing convoluted. It's not like we need to make three piles of two and then you need to divide one number by another number. It's direct mentalism. It's name a number, bam, in the envelope. There's a number written down.
This was something that excited me when I saw the trailer, because I kind of didn't know what it was achieving
and what it was for.
And this is a box. It's a plastic box that holds business cards, and you see Matthew using this on the DVD, and he's got a box with business cards, and he's got one black envelope in the top, and he puts the lid on and he places this in their hands, and then he asks them the number, he opens up the box, takes out the envelope, and goes into the same routine that we just previously described, guessing how much change is in my pocket or anything like that, but you predict the amount. The box, I guess it kind of helps your pocket management a little bit, but for me, and it provides a nice moment of misdirection as well when you say put the lid back on, but for me, this looks a bit proppy and a bit magic-y.
Well, it is.
And it looks a bit more like toy shop magic, so although it might make the trick easier to perform, we prefer the solution of envelope within an envelope.
If I was going at a gig, I'd be doing the envelope, however... There are scenarios, there's lots of magicians, especially in the UK, that are going to these breakfast meeting clubs when they're all pulling out their business card boxes.
Yeah.
And yada. And in that scenario, that's a perfectly real thing to be doing. And again, if you want to be giving your business card out at the end of it, that's your solution.
And, you know, the case has been custom made to make it easier to carry all the gimmicks inside in a very, sort of, like we said, disarming way that means you can show the envelope to start with, put the envelope back in the box, and then when you take your envelope out, you're completely free to perform the effect and operate
Absolutely.
The method that is needed to create this unbelievable prediction on the fly. It's hard to say too much more about it. Like I said, downloadable instructions. I think it was about an hour, hosted by Bro Gilbert. The highlight, once again, was a part of the DVD. You didn't see any live performances, the bit that I went through, and that was a shame because on the trailer, you saw some great reactions from live performances. I would have liked to have seen the full live performance from the trailer to see how it was achieved. But what you did see, which was the highlight of the DVD instruction for me, was Matthew performing the effect on a lady in his home. By the way, Matthew, make your bed. And if you're not going to make your bed, don't have it on camera. Because he kept panning over, didn't it? And you saw his bedroom in the background. All his beds are smashed to bits. So the lady was there. I hope you made it by the time she came round. She's on the sofa. And you saw it from an exposed point of view. And he did the whole routine with the box. And it looked very, very clean indeed. I just don't like the box. I think it's a little bit proppy, even though it might make it easier to perform.
Mm-hmm.
What do you think to this?
I think it's brilliant.
The only downside, I think, is the price. I think it's a little bit too much for what you get, but it is a very specialised and very well-made piece of kit.
I just want to say it's mentalism, and mentalism, because of how powerful mentalism is generally priced a little bit more than the usual magic trick.
It is, I suppose.
So
I think it's a little bit, I think it's a tenner too much. Personally, that's stopping me from rating it a little bit higher than I would normally. But still, we both like it. Mm-hmm. Everybody unanimously likes it, is very impressed with the gimmick, how well it's made. It functions perfectly. We're giving this a worker of the week.
We are giving it worker of the week.
And because Freedom Writer is this week's Worker of the Week, if you order it before midnight on Friday, we will include in your order the Sudoku Book Test by Scott Creasy. It's awesome. You've got stuff in there. You've got a regular book test. You've got drawing duplications, and it ends with a wicked magic square routine. So get your orders in before midnight on Friday, and you will get the Sudoku Book Test included free.
So it's getting Worker of the Week. How much are you going to give it?
93%.
I'm giving it 92%.
Excellent, that blows the 9% formula then.
So we've got quite a bit on this week's show. So Paul Harris presents Mark Allen's Freedom Writer with Bro Gilbert and Matthew Johnson. I can't believe that I remembered all that. Nice bit of kit for mentalism. Triage, not really impressed by that at all. The gimmick is very good, but we didn't like the routine. What do you think to that?
It was okay.
It was okay, good gimmick, bit worried about the fatigue, but still very, very well made. Nicely shot DVD, even though not on a huge budget. And the Tango set of poker chips with the gimmick that you might find on the beach. Very, very well made. You can follow us in all the usual places, and it's been a long time now since we've mentioned the Lads Convention.
The what convention?
The Lads Convention. It's the last Sunday in September. Hosted by World Magic Shop, and we've got a lot of new dealers this year, haven't we, John? Extra dealers, and in the next week we will be announcing two brand new names that will be lecturing at Lads this year, as well as Morgan Strebler and Aaron Jones. So you can check that out on worldmagicshop.com, as well as all these other products.
All of them.
Follow us in all the usual places, facebook.com/worldmagicshop. Follow us on the YouTube channel and on the Magic Cafe as well. That's it for this week. We'll see you in 2 weeks' time.
2 weeks' time.
Yeah, he remembered it. On the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
And I'm Sean.
We'll see you next week.
Why do you do it?